brushstrokes give the painting energy. But, you know, because if you're just filling in, you're never going to get the energy that these paintings have.
And you said that you're an art painter.
Really an art painter, yeah.
All right, mate, thank you.
See you later.
Show us how that would work.
Well, you know, when you paint one of these, you have a brush, and you go like this.
You draw them up first, then.
Yeah, they're drawn very carefully, and then when I paint, I sort of screw up the drawing.
Said that you're an art painter.
Really an art painter, yeah.
Show us how that would work.
Well, you know, when you paint one of these, you have a brush and you have energy.
Somewhere in the city?
Here at 36.
Is it a busy night?
I think so. Yeah. It's busy for coronavirus happening there.
Oh, shit.
Cool. squeeze by everybody. 4 years ago, we were talking and, you know, over time, just to see Mr. Kulik?
Right. No, this is, well, yeah, it's a combination. It presents like a painting. It's essentially like a panel with canvas over it.
Right.
And then it's a combination of a painted acrylic, paper. There's paper. I use a lot of punching.
I see that.
And, you know, most of the paper is tinted. I use pigments or acrylic or color concentrates. And then some of it is naked paper. It's just like, raw, like a rag.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations on the show, brother.
But to put art where people live, because I think, art has an incredible potential to affect people emotionally and intellectually and create conversations. So the way that music works, things like Johnny Cash, Public Enemy, Bob, Bob Marley, Clash, I think visual art should do more of that. It should affect people viscerally, and be very democratic. Viscerally can be very democratic and accessible. So viscerally, Bob Marley, Clash. I pretty much my whole
affect people emotionally and intellectually, conversation.